The upper middle or the lower middle?
Middle. What section is that?
I mean, actually, can we go back to, like, I guess, sort of the preface? I was particularly fascinated by Kant's idea that his new system, kind of like a new Copernican like revolution in shifting the cosmos.
Yeah, I was interested in that, especially in the fundamental shift between them due to technology and the hundreds of years since. It was a reinterpretation of the mathematical data that Ptolemy and previous thinkers had already written down.
Yeah, I mean, that's something, but, like, I think I have a slightly different reading of the text. To me, it rested not on Copernicus's shifting intuitions on the existing materials, but simplifying in such a way as to allow for a new religious understanding, a monotheist religion instead of a pagan one. At least that seems more likely to me than a purely mathematical one, as you were saying.
That's interesting. I knew you'd go back to your precious Ptolemy, which is why I took the liberty bring my copy of On the Revolution of the Heavenly Spheres, with key passages marked that back up my claim.
There's no need for that, Mr. Gordon. See, I suspected you would go to the source material, which is why I took the liberty of bringing Ptolemy's Almagest with me tonight, to demonstrate the inherent flaw in Copernicus's understanding of the work as an expansion of his paganistic beliefs. What do you think about that?
I knew you'd run to your precious Ptolemy, which is why I brought the original text of Almagest with me, showing a common mistranslation of your Green Lion translation. Picking good translations was never your strong suit, Mr. Katz.
And translation was never yours, Gordon. Do you think I didn't remember freshman Greek with you? You couldn't translate to save your life, which is why I knew you would go to Mr. Schiller's Greek assistance. What you didn't suspect is that I paid him off with his only weakness. Leather shoes.
Sweet Jesus.
I had him purposely mislead your translation to lead you to this seminar room with a woefully misaligned understanding of the source material. How counter you, villain?
Foolish fool! People always were your blind spot. Unbeknownst to you, Mr. Schiller could never keep a secret. Especially to people he loves. He told your devilish scheme to his boyfriend, Mr. Bowman, at their last double-dated Killwinds. Little did he know I'd already employed Mr. Bowman months ago to gather any information about you in the seminar.
Bowman and Schiller are dating?
It'll be a month tomorrow. They've had a lovely time, but Mr. Schiller's been looking for a way to end the relationship without hurting Mr. Bowman's feelings.
What?!
You filthy scholastic! You think I didn't come with a backup? I have passages later in the book that agree with me. I have a fully prepared speech on B278.
You ran ahead of today's reading? You bloody dogmatist! I'll kill you!
Up, 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 up! Look above you.
What sophistry is this?
Not sophistry. Just planning. I would never hinge my plans on translation. That's why, before seminar tonight, I tied a water balloon to a string above your seat. Any last words, Gordon?
How are you supposed to make the balloons fall down?
I knew you would call my water balloon bluff. That's why I installed a second balloon on top of the water balloon you see above your head. This one connected to a pair of scissors connected to my phone, which will activate when I push this button.
What? Where did you even get those scissors?
I bought them from an anonymous buyer of the dark web, engineered in the Makala Mountains of Tibet. The seller visited me 3 days ago in the restroom. I go the extra mile for quality.
Fine. But before you finish me, you might want to check your blind spot.
just business, Katz.
Just business? We translated Antigone together. You were at my daughter's baptism!
That Madeline died a long time ago. Don't make this any harder than it has to be.
Mother would be disappointed in you.
Don't bring Mother into this!
Madeline, you're a professional!
I'm sorry.
No. I'm sorry. Take the shot, Al-Khatib. Al-Khatib.
Call him all you want! Backup is not coming!
What did you do to him, you monster?
It's no secret that Al-Khatib has an allergy to cats. It was merely a matter of placing a cat nearby when they had taken up the sniper position. It's not difficult to guess your plans. I saw you sketching possible sniper positions in the seminar. You're utterly predictable.
How dare you pull him into this? Well, no matter. You didn't plan for my little friend.
Wrong again, Mr. Katz! I knew you would bring an EpiPen to treat his allergic reaction. So I hired Cameron Byerly to wait on top of a vending machine in a onesie with a toaster ready.
Wait. I didn't say EpiPen.
What?
I didn't say EpiPen. I said little friend. I've had this water pistol pointed at you this entire time under the desk between your legs, and it's just, yeah.
You didn't say EpiPen.
No.
You didn't bring an EpiPen to save Al-Khatib.
No. Why would I do that, you idiot? Why would I think that you're going to purposefully induce a reaction in one of our friends?
Oh,
he might be dead. I can't help but feel that I'm at least partially responsible for this. I wanted to thank you for giving me this ring. I swear I've seen it before, but it's pretty. Anyway, you were a great friend, and we... I miss you. You'll be happy to know that Katz and I settled our differences. We got together. We put together a piece of legislation to outlaw our rambunctious mid-seminar fights. The campus is safer now. People have to settle things personally, not by developing complicated, multifaceted treachery plots. You know? It might be more virtuous this way. I wish you could see it. Anyway, your death made everything come together so perfectly. It's almost as if you...
Scissors!
I'm an anonymous buyer of the dark web. Bowman and Schiller are dating?
It'll be a month tomorrow. My last double dated kill wins.
You think I didn't come with a backup? Take the shot, Al-Khatib. Al-Khatib.
It's no secret that Al-Khatib has an allergy to cats.
Why would I think that you're going to purposefully induce a reaction in one of our friends?